Good morning, students. Today we will continue the chapter 20, the United Nations. We had already seen how United Nations was formed, when, and what were its principles and its main objectives. Now we have to see bodies of the UN. So we will take book page number 105. The UN has 6 major bodies to carry out activity. So United Nations has got 6 different bodies, 6 different department, we can say, okay, subdivisions, which will help the different works to go on. So the first one we have, the General Assembly. The General Assembly's main body of United Nations is the General Assembly. It's like a world parliament. Like we have parliament where all the members come and meet. Same way we have world parliament, which is General Assembly. Each member nation has one vote in. So all the members of different countries, from one member from each country, yani ek desh se एक वोट इसमें जरूर जाता है. व्हाट आर द फंक्शन, करता है क्या है जनरल असेंबली? द फर्स्ट थिंग, टू एडमिट न्यू मेंबर्स. इफ वन मोर नेशन वांट्स टू जॉइन द यूनाइटेड नेशन, एडमिटिंग इट, ओके, उसको स्वीकार करना, लेना. टू अपॉइंट सेक्रेटरी जनरल ऑफ द यूएन ऑन द रिकमेंडेशन ऑफ सिक्योरिटी काउंसिल. So they have this General Assembly where all the members are there voting, choosing. They choose Security General, okay? To elect 10 temporary members of the Security Council. In a General Assembly, people also from different nation, one vote they put, who should be the 10 temporary members, who should be the General Secretary General, okay? And to pass the annual budget. Annual budget means कौन सा पैसा, कितना पैसा, कहाँ यूज होना है. Which are the undeveloped areas or places in different countries, or health, education, or any other issues where they need to spend money. To receive and discuss reports of main bodies of the UN. And all the reports of the United Nations to discuss. So what happens in General Assembly? In General Assembly, one member of each country will be there. They will vote and choose a General Secretary or Secretary General. They will also choose 10 temporary members. They will also have the power to admit new member and pass annual budget, and then discuss reports of whole year, receive the report and discuss it. That is the General Assembly, like World Parliament, where Lok Sabha, like we have a parliament, no? Lok Sabha, Rajya Sabha members meet. Like that only, where all the members of the world leaders meet. Second one we have, the Security Council. What it is work? The Security Council is executive body. Executive body means जो काम कराते हैं, the one who will put forth the plan into action. Okay? So it is the most important organ of the UN. This is the very important organ, or we can say संगठन का एक सबसे important हिस्सा है. It consists of 2 types of members. There are 2 members in the Security Council, permanent members and non-permanent. Its total strength is 15, out of which 5 are permanent and 10 are temporary. Okay? Understood? So, in Security Council, there are 15 members, 5 permanent and 10 non-permanent. UK, USA, Russia, China, France. They are the permanent members, and remaining 10 members are chosen from different countries, okay, by the General Assembly for a term of 2 years. So the different members from different 10 countries, they are chosen and they are chosen for 2 years only. After them, somebody else will be chosen. So they will not be chosen. Maybe we choose them this 2 years, and next again 2 years we may not, we should not choose. We have to choose them after some time. So those 10 members, those who are chosen temporarily, only for 2 years. Okay. The permanent members have veto power. In the book it is given veto power. Na? Veto power means the power to refuse. तो पांच जो सदस्य हैं परमानेंट, उन हर एक के पास वीटो पावर है कि वो रिफ्यूज़ कर सकते हैं किसी भी चीज़ के लिए. मे बी कोई एक प्लान बना और उसमें से चार सदस्य अग्री हो गए कि या दिस इज ओके, वी शुड पास इट ऑन, ये काम होना चाहिए. बट वन मेंबर डिसअग्रीज, नो इट शुड नॉट, देन दैट प्लान विल नॉट बी पास्ड ऑन, इट विल बी रीडिस्कस्ड इन द जनरल असेंबली. क्लियर? समझ में आया? सो द परमानेंट 5 मेंबर्स हैव वीटो पावर्स, पावर टू रिफ्यूज टू एक्सेप्ट एनीथिंग. सो इफ चार लोग एक्सेप्ट करते हैं और एक एक्सेप्ट नहीं करता है या दो, देन दे हैव टू नॉट पास दैट एंड रीडिस्कस इट इन टू द जनरल असेंबली. Okay, so the matter is not passed, it will have to be discussed and voted again later. The main function of the Security Council is to stop all conflicts in the world. Koi jhagda nahi hona chahiye, main function yahi hai. All the thing has to be discussed and solved. So to have talks to maintain peace and to send peacekeeping forces against a nation which becomes a threat to the international peace. So they have to see to maintain peace, and if there is a nation who is giving threat to the other nation, then the Security Council has to send peacekeeping as the force, not a force which is going to fight and all, a peacekeeping force to stop that nation to give threat or harm to the other nation. Okay. Third one we have the Economic and Social Council. So did you understand about the Security Council? 15 members are there, 5 are permanent, 10 are temporary, chosen only for 2 years, and the 5 one have got, all each have got veto power, where they can refuse to accept any matter which will be discussed later. The main function of the Security Council is to maintain peace, okay, in the nations. Now, Economic and Social Council. The council has 54 members countries. So, in the Economic and Social Council, there are 54 members from different 54 countries elected by the General Assembly. So, these members are also elected by the General Assembly. The tenure of a member is 3 years. So the member, those who are chosen for the Economic and Social Council, they are chosen for 3 years. Okay, 1/3 of its members retire every year. So 1/3 members will retire. Okay, if there are 12 members, 9 will retire. Okay, every year a new 9 will be chosen. No retired member can be replaced immediately. If somebody has retired, it will not be replaced immediately. So it meets twice a year, at April and June. So the council, which is Economic and Social Council, they meet twice in a year, once in April and in July. What are their work? Why do they meet? What do they discuss? To collect data in respect to economic, social एंड एजुकेशनल. तो हर एक देश की रिपोर्ट इकट्ठी करनी होती है उन्हें कि वहाँ का सोशल स्टेटस क्या है, कल्चरल क्या है, इकोनॉमिक स्टेटस क्या है, हेल्थ कैसी है वहाँ पे, एजुकेशन कैसी है वहाँ पे. ओके, टू गेट द रिपोर्ट ऑफ डिफरेंट, जितने भी मेंबर्स हैं हर एक देश की रिपोर्ट इकट्ठी करनी होती है कि वहाँ क्या इकोनॉमिक, सोशल, हेल्थ, एजुकेशन एंड ऑल दीज थिंग्स हाउ दे आर गोइंग अबाउट. Second thing, what they have to do, Economic and Social Council members, to promote economic and social cooperation. to help each other economically and socially. This is also the work of Economic and Social Council. Understood? This was your third organization. Fourth, the Trusteeship Council. Now this Trusteeship Council is no more working. The Trusteeship Council was formed to work for the countries which were led by the colonial government. Colonial government like British, we were ruled by Britishers, European countries. Na kisi aur country ka, kisi aur country pe rule hona. That was colonial. So nowadays all the countries are free from the colonial rule. So this organization is no more there. Okay, so Trusteeship Council is set up in 1945. At that time many countries were ruled by the colonial powers from the European powers. Okay, they used to come and settle and make their own colonies there, and the rights and everything was there taken away from the native people. There are 11 such nations, but now all of them are free. So that's why this organization is no more working. There are other two more organizations which we will be learning into the next class. We have learned about four organizations. General Assembly, okay? General Assembly, the Security Council and the Economic. In General Assembly, all the members come and meet together. Okay, and the vote of each nation, one vote is required. And in Security Council, there are 15 members, 5 permanent, 10 non-permanent. Economic and Social group has to maintain the report of all social, economic, health, educational, cultural report. And this organization is no more working. Rest of the organization we will learn in the next class. Till then, study about them. Have a good day. Bye.